Hi everyone, Grant K here for the Flame Premium Learning Channel. In the previous video, we went through the underlying fundamentals of the centralized workflow. This included updating open clips, versioning batch setups, and the batch write node. All the versioning was done in the context of the timeline on a single Flame system, however, all the data was accessed externally from a central location. In this video, we will take what was explained previously and expand out to a multi-system VFX shot pipeline. So currently, I am on a Flame workstation that contains the master timeline. I have started working on a few comps here and there, and I would like to hand this off to the other VFX artists in the pipeline. So we are going to switch over to Flare running on a Mac, and we'll pick up the VFX shots that were assigned to this station. Now I'd like to remind you that the workflow would be the same using Flame, Flare, or Flame Assist on Linux. The big point is that each system must be mapped to the same common path to the central location of the job tree. In terms of setting up a project, you could remotely connect into the other Flame project, create a new workspace, and move things around. However, you can also work in different projects. But ultimately, the workflow will be the same because the data is in a centralized location in the facility. So this Flare is in its own project, and currently nothing is loaded in the desktop or library. If I want to work on Shot 60, I would click the Batch Load button. In the file browser, I would navigate to the central job tree and locate my shot. In this case, it's in /san/autodeskjobs/fplc_vfx-shot-publish/shot-60. So for this VFX shot, I have a batch directory, a DPX directory, an input directory, and an output directory. Since we are working with batch setups in the VFX pipeline, you will navigate into the batch directory. Now we have access to the original batch setup, as well as any versioned batch setups that may have been created on other systems. So if I load the first batch setup, here you will see the open clip source nodes and the write node. If I go back to the load menu and load the batch setup I started in the other Flame system, you will see the modified flow graph and you could carry on working on this shot. So it doesn't really matter which system in the VFX pipeline has previously accessed the shot. Ultimately, all systems have access to all the media and metadata setups to get the job done. I'd also like to stress that if you need to import any additional elements into the composite, you need to ensure that you use the common file path to access the imagery. This means wherever the setups are loaded, the media will be loaded correctly. So this Flare is tasked with compositing the screen replacement properly. In the interests of time, I have already prepared a custom node and I'll drag that out and connect it into the pipeline. As a quick reminder, make sure your last node in the flow graph is connected to the write node. Double-clicking on the write node, you will see all the matching paths that every system will be writing to. And as before, if you have a custom pipeline in your facility, you can customize the paths to match your file naming and directory conventions. The version number will auto-increment each time you render to the write node. So you can build various versions of your VFX shot, and you will also have all the batch setups for each version in the assigned batch directory. The batch setups are automatically saved when you press render, so you don't need to do this as a separate operation. In summary, whether you're using two systems or 20 systems, the workflow is the same. You load the batch setup into Flame, Flare, or Flame Assist. You build your composite, and you render a version back out to a central location with the write node. Let's round trip back to the Flame system that contains the master timeline. In this system, you could be working on a different composite, or perhaps finishing off another VFX shot. However, if you go to Shot 60 and select it, the Clip Versions pull-down menu will update with any new versions relating to the shot. So the media was rendered, and the open clip was updated, and Flame instantly registers this information. Now all of these shots could be work in progress, or even complete. If you have to refine or complete any of the VFX work for a shot, you can just select the segment, and either click on Create New Version or Append to Batch. So in terms of a collaborative VFX pipeline, VFX shots can constantly round-trip through any system, but everything is always kept in one place. When it comes to choosing which version you see in a segment, you have a few choices. In the Source Version submenu, you can just update the source. This means that the open clip will be refreshed for any new versions, but the selected segment will not automatically update to a new version. Select Current Version allows the facility to set which version they'd like to use in Flame, and this does not necessarily need to be the latest version. By default, the latest version is also set as the current version. However, you can use external scripts to modify the OpenClip file when required. And finally, to ensure you are looking at the latest available version of the shot, you would choose Select Latest Version. Further expanding on these concepts, to update to the latest version for every shot in the sequence, perhaps during a client approval session, right-click on the sequence clip in the media panel and update it to the latest version. You can do this as many times in every situation to ensure that those last-minute changes are definitely in the sequence when it comes to the final approval. In summary, the VFX Shot Publish workflow is a very powerful tool. It helps facilitate a centralized collaborative environment with the Flame products. The workflow requires a common path to a central location to access all the media, setups, and metadata. When working between all the different Flame products, regardless of platform, the batch setups, write notes, and open clips help automate the versioning process to keep things moving along. The VFX Shot Publish workflow is quite open to customizations in terms of your facility's job tree and specific requirements. It is also possible to work with third-party applications in the VFX pipeline using the common file paths. This can further be enhanced by updating the open clips manually or with custom automated Python scripts to make the Flame sequence aware of any versions coming from other third-party applications. I hope you've enjoyed the series on the VFX Shot Publish workflow. More videos will be added to this series in the future. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Premium Learning Channel for future videos.